What is the departure point between these two things? If Rastafari is that good thing that you have talked, that you have spoken of, why persecuting those good things? What are the forces that are opposing here? What are the forces that are opposing here? Because those words, good words that you have talked, anyone can feel that those are the things that should be cherished or embraced. But why all those persecution throughout the history of the Rastafari movement?
Because one have to realize the world that I and I are living in.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
So when Rastafari said Babylon, what does that mean?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that term Babylon.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I and I look in the earth and see who is running the earth. Yeah?
Who is running the earth?
Yes, this earth, this planet earth right now. Who running it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
And it comes down to man. So which man and which set of man and which group of people are running the planet Earth right now?
Yeah.
Yes?
Okay.
So I identify them. Yes?
Yeah.
Now next one says it's a global, we're living in a global white supremacy system. Yeah? Global white supremacy system. Yeah?
Yeah.
And some call that racism.
Racism, yeah.
Yeah? But it's a global white supremacy system. See? And they run the earth through 9 areas of people power, according to Francis Creswell, see? And Neil Fuller Jr. Nine areas of people power they control.
Could you mention them?
Economics, education, entertainment, labor law, politics, religion, sex and war.
Yeah?
Economics. They control economics.
Okay.
The resources.
The economy of the world.
The resources of Africa is not used for the benefit of the Africans.
Mm-hmm.
Africa is the richest continent on the planet, yet them have the poorest people. Outcomes. And these countries have been independent for how many years now?
Yeah, more than 60 years.
More than 60 years, and they have independence. And I can't see any form of, development.
Mm-hmm.
But the development that should be made by Africans.
And
with
for
the resources. And for Africans. Who else? Yeah? With the resources that Africa has, then the people them should be better off.
So yeah? the Africans now, they are not on that, they are not the title contender on that economy.
Because we're living in a global white supremacy system.
Mm-hmm.
The white man is at the top of the ladder and the black man is at the bottom.
Mm-hmm.
And the point is that they don't want that status quo to change. Because
mm-hmm.
if the black man then rises up
okay.
to his full potential, and Africa
mm-hmm.
rises up to its full potential of the minerals and
mm-hmm.
the wealth that it has,
that
suddenly Africa is the wealthiest continent.
Yes.
And the people are the wealthiest. That means to say there's a change, a revolution.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
And so this is what I and I are seeing right about now.
Mm-hmm.
What I and I are seeing, right, is that the white supremacists
mm-hmm.
striving to hold on to their power. Yeah? By locking down the whole wide world.
Okay.
Yeah?
But some will say that in that big problem that you've talked about, I mean those 9 points, I mean, to me, I will call them realms. Yeah? Realms. Yeah?
Whatever you want.
Yeah, yeah. But some will argue that Africans themselves have the role to play to the state of their affairs. I mean, it's like a blame game. But they say they are also responsible for that. Look now, you have all these kind of leaders in Africa. You have this kind who accept these leaders to be their leaders. You see, so. What is the contributions of Africa, of Africans themselves, in the continent and in the living spora or diaspora per se, to the current state of affairs in Africa? Do we have any role, we as Africans?
You see, that kind of question, really and truthfully,
mm-hmm.
I find it strange.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, what are you saying?
Mm-hmm.
Why?
Mm-hmm.
Because. And I went through colonialism. Africa continent went through colonialism.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, where the white man was on top. The Indian man in the middle, mm-hmm. and then the black man at the bottom
yeah.
And that run in England, and that run in throughout Africa, America, the Caribbean, mm-hmm. and in England, and anywhere I and I black people are on the planet.
Yeah.
Yeah? So from that is the conditions that I and I are in. We have ones who have come to uplift black people.
Yeah.
And to uplift them people.
Yeah.
Yeah? Mm-hmm. And so I and I see Yesi Lassia is that, such a one.
Such
Marcus
a, yeah.
Garvey is such a one. Mm-hmm. Yehova. Yeah, yeah. Malcolm X. Different ones.
Yeah.
Come in.
Men and women.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Right? From all over black world.
Alright. Mm-hmm. So here we had Nyerere in those Nyerere, times, yes. of independence, fighting to get one
Kumas.
Then Kumas of the world. Sankara.
Amilcar Cabral,
yeah. Amilcar Cabral, you can go on all the way forward,
yeah.
in all the countries. These were the ones that fight to get the independence. But now you have the independence, what are you going to do with it?
With it, yes.
And Kwame Nkrumah did one about neocolonialism. Mm-hmm. You see, that's why I talk about neocolonialism. Mm-hmm. Imperialism,
yes.
the ugly head again.
Yeah.
To divide and rule and divide and conquer.
Yes,
so one needs to know what situation we in and stop eluding themselves. Yeah?
Yeah.
Marcus Garvey said, up your mighty race, you can accomplish what you will.
Without confidence.
We are a long-suffering people, mm-hmm. and we deem to suffer no longer. Mm-hmm. So why should Africans be suffering? And they've got the minerals under their feet,
yeah.
and resources under their feet to be wealthy.
Petroleum,
everything,
forest, whatever you can mention.
But, all right.
Yeah.